This? Can you hear me? This? This?
Hey, good girl now.
This?
Doing okay, girl?
This?
You'll be okay. Coming on, girl.
Oh, shit.
Damn it, Abe. I said, Abe,
yes, sir.
Where are the other hands?
I thought I said I don't rightly know, Mr. Getty, sir.
Well, what good is that to me? We got three horses lost, possibly more, a mare about to foal,
sir,
and no hands to help with any of it. I'm supposed to be heading into town. This place is chaos.
Hey, Pa! Can I get some help? Pa!
Milton, you good with horses?
I'm okay. I'll do whatever needs doing, sir.
Good man. Can you help my boy, my youngest Duncan? He will insist on riding Jeremiah, a horse that is far too strong for him. And my wife will need help with this mare. Abe?
Sir?
You and Dickens better not make any more mistakes like you did today, you hear?
No, sir.
Thank you. Both of you.
Come on, he's over here.
I'm good. You get on. Go find them horses.
No. I'll show you. Since you showed up, runaway horse has been to some of our problems. And I am thankful for that.
I ain't done too much. I ain't much of a rancher.
Oh, heck.
Hey, maybe them Laramie boys weren't so tough after all, huh? Maybe I could have handled them.
Of course you could. They're just loud mouths.
Yeah.
So, is that what the boss is doing in town? Some business with them boys or something?
Well, when Mr. Geddes goes into town, well, it ain't exactly for, business.
Oh. Okay, then.
All right. He'll be just at the end there. Well, I better get to.
Thanks, kid. Duncan? I'm Jim. Jim Milton.
Hey.
Need a hand with that horse?
No.
Whoa. You sure about that?
Okay,
relax.
Yes, I do.
Pretty big one. Oh, hey. Easy now. Easy.
Well, that's Jeremiah.
Okay, Jeremiah. There, boy. Come on. Easy, boy. Oh, someone put some onions on their oats, didn't they, boy? Oh. Calm down.
He likes you.
Ain't sure he likes any of us, but I'll make him respect me and behave.
Can't you teach me how to make him behave same way as he does for you?
I'm supposed to go help your mother. She's got a horse in foal.
That'll take hours.
Well, training a horse can take hours.
Just give me a quick lesson, sir. Please.
Okay. I'm gonna take him out first. Burn some of this heat off of him.
I'll be in the corral, Ben.
Good horse. Hey, boy. Hey, feller. Good boy. good boy. It's all right, ain't it? You're a good boy. Good lad. There's a boy. Some energy? Show me this. Okay. That was fun, wasn't it? You can behave now, can't you? All right. He's ready for you.
Okay.
Get on up there and go nice and slow. Stay calm.
Me?
The horse. You're calm.
My heart's beating a little.
Keep your voice calm and your legs strong. Don't let old Jeremiah sense fear.
I won't.
Doing fine. Real nice. Not that I'm saying you need one, but you sure there isn't another horse you ride around here?
I had a pony, but I'm too grown for him now.
Yeah? You think my son could borrow him?
Huh. Lancelot?
Yeah.
Sure. I'll get it hitched by your cabin there.
All right. Thank you, son.
Can I ask? Are we in trouble from all these Laramie boys? They say Mr. Abel's real rich. Way richer than Pa. And he's got all these hired guns. Out of Laramie, and if Pa doesn't sell, well, they'll come here and they'll...
Hey, easy there. You don't have to worry about all that. You just worry about Jeremiah there.
Yeah, but...
Hello, hello?
But...
Just worry about the horse. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
I think you two might be ready to go out without a chaperone.
Oh, I'm not sure about that.
You're good. Nice and easy now. Both of you.
Can you hear me?
You Mr. Milton? I thought you were gonna help me.
I am. I was. I'm sorry.
Come on. I need a man's help. Duncan, what have I told you about distracting the hands?
I'm sorry, Ma.
Well, I hope you'll listen to me better than my
Thank
husband.
Thank you, Mr. Milton.
You're doing fine, kid. Give him a carrot when you put him down.
So, you know much about birthing a foal, Milton?
Not too much.
My God, where does my husband find men like you? Still, we all know where he goes in town, and it ain't hunting for hands. It's not too hard. You just stick a hand in there and get a feeling for where the legs are. Go on.
Whatever you say, ma'am.
Okay, now hold on. Find them, Milton.
Oh, I lost it.
Come on. It's coming out one way or another. Grab them again. And more. Hold them, Milton. Okay, well, I think she's... Well, we're not out of the woods, but I think she may be okay.
Great.
We'll make a proper hand of you yet, Mr. Milton.
I hope so.
Thank you. Oh, and Mr. Milton... Feel free to make a call at the house sometime. Perhaps even now. A drink to toast our new arrival.
I'd like that, but my wife is expecting me back.
Oh, you're married? I didn't know we had any married hands.
Yeah, we have a boy. Maybe you've seen him around?
Oh, I'm busy. Too busy for social calls.
Of course.
Good day, Mr. Milton.
Hey, John.
Jim.
Sorry.
So, this is what you wanted. Fake names, which, by the way, Dickens sees clean through.
John.
Us on the run.
John, this is our chance to make something new.
This.
Come on. Please. For me. For him.
How's he been?
Kind of withdrawn. Quiet. You know.
Sure.
Take him out, please.
Come on, boy. Let's go for a walk.
No.
Come on.
I have a mic.
Round to the left. What do you see?
A pony?
Get on him. We're taking a ride. Duncan, Mr. Getty's boy lent it to you. Let's go. How you doing?
Fine. Can we go home?
No. You're... Stay calm. Where would you like to go riding, aside from home?
I don't know. But maybe that stream?
Good idea. Now, you know all this. Get him going. Come on. You know. The horse can feel your fear. Just act confident, okay?
Uh-huh. Confident. Yep.
Don't pull on the reins. You'll yank his bit out. Use your legs. There you are. Now let's go. Jack, a little kick and a... See, you can do it. How about you speed up a mic?
Okay. Whoa! What's happening? Help!
Easy there! Easy there!
Whoa!
Jack! You okay?
Damn.
Watch your language. You okay?
Yeah, I think so.
You'd know it if you weren't. Get back on.
Okay.
All right. Let's go again.
Ha!
Why don't we speed it up again?
Okay. Come on.
Even faster, come on.
Faster?
We can go even quicker.
If you say so, sir. Yeah.
Now really stick your boot in.
If you say so. Come on, boy.
Faster now. Come on.
Sir, if I go any faster, he'll buck me again.
Okay. See? You're learning. Okay. Let's go across to the stream.
Yes, sir.
Whoa, easy. Keep going, girl. You're okay. Here we are.
Yep.
I know you fell, but you think you're ready for a little race?
I'll be fine.
All right. We go back to the path and up to the ranch.
Okay. On my go. Go! I beat you! I beat you!
Well ridden, son.
I beat you.
Like I said, your riding has gotten so much better.
Thanks.
Hey, keep practicing your riding.
You too. You need it. I'm headed to work today myself, Jack.
Huh?
So you stay out of trouble.
Where are you working?
I told you. Cleaning at the doctor's office. Bye.
Bye.
Get the place a tidy.
Okay, Pa.
I'll see you later. Horse!
Hey, Milton, can you give me a hand with this fence?
Sure.
Know much about fence building?
Not really.
Can't build a fence, can't milk a cow, ain't used to shoveling shits, but took on a gang of robbers single-handed.
Guess we all got our peculiarities, Mr. Dickens.
What was you doing before you came here?
I told you. Wife got cheated out of inheritance. We was in a legal dispute. It was a bad time.
That sounds awful, but I guess I don't believe a word of it.
I was raised to take a man at his word, and also to believe this is a free country. So free that I can't tell you what to think. So I guess it don't much matter what you believe. But I will work hard, and I learn fast.
Okay. Give me a hand with this fence. Yep, there's plenty more to do. Pound it in there. We don't want it coming down. Okay, again. Good. Now grab a rail, line it up with a notch, and place it in. Now, lift up the other side. They gotta line up, see? Now the next rail. Good. Fine. Okay. That looks okay. Go to the next post and pound that in. I hope you've grasped the basics. I got other matters to attend to, but there's more than a day's work here for you.
All right. So long.
I'll be counting sections when you're done.
Okay.
Jim Milton, over here. Put that fence down and get over here, boy. Hurry. Hurry. Quick as you can. Milton, get over here.
Coming.
Come on, give us a hand. Know much about bulls, Milton?
Just the basics. Don't make them mad.
Angus Geddes, this is Jim Milton.
Mr. Milton?
Angus is your boss's son.
Nice to meet you. Let's try and move this great hunk of chuck.
Come on! Move!
Move!
Shit!
I'll get him!
Get him along, Milton. And try and calm him down.
Let's talk. Stop. Shit. No. Don't. I gotta build that. Like you're gonna wind down, but I'll try. There. It ain't so bad. Nice and easy now, boy. Stop. Whoa there. Easy. All better? Okay. Now come on, you hunk of chuck. Come on. Got him, Mr. Dickens.
Oh, good.
How you doing, son?
A bit sore, but I'll be okay. Thank you, Mr. Milton.
My pleasure. And you, mister?
Fine. He just got my head.
Good. There he is.
See you later, Jim Milton. We'll make a rancher of you yet.
Right. Be back.
You want to watch your mouth, boy. You will be the first one we kill.
Leave him alone.
Oh, careful, boys. Careful.
Yeah.
Look at this tough guy.
Get out of here.
Oh, fancy pants Geddes paying you to be tough for him, huh?
No, he's paying me to keep the place clean.
Oh.
Said he had some problems with vermin.
Oh, listen to this. Real funny.
No!
Come on, get him.
I'll kick his head in, boss!
It's like that, huh? I'm gonna smell like cow dung, boys.
Oh, he's licking you, boss!
Jim Milton, get off that man! Get off
him! He hit me first.
Oh, you can fight, boy. I'll give you that. Well, how's your wife in a brawl?
Leave my wife alone.
Oh, she's real pretty.
Get out of here.
Oh, quite a temper you got. Imagine you're frustrated with your lot in life, married to a shit-shoveling farmhand. What'd you do wrong to end up here?
Leave my wife alone.
Welcome to Big Valley, Jim Milton. Pleasure to meet you both. We'll see you again. And you, boy, tell Mr. Geddes we called. We'll be back.
Thank you, Mr. Milton. Thank you.
Don't worry about it.
Stop acting like a goddamn storybook hero, will ya?
What choice did I have?
Plenty, you moron. Plenty.
We all get caught eventually, John. I guess the trick is to decide by who.
Now, dear, I won't hear any more of it.
You won't hear any of it.
Not in front of the men.
You toad!
All right, smile, smile. Do not embarrass me. Mr. Milton, I should like to have...
Mr. Geddes?
Hey, I heard we had another incident with the Laramie boys.
Yeah, there was an incident.
Well, I mean to scare me.
Are you scared?
A little. I've got a lot invested in this place, and not just the land, but my family. It's hard to explain.
I understand. I'll do my best to keep you safe, sir.
I know you will. So how's your family?
Just fine. I should probably head back.
Yeah, I know how it is.
How'd you get on?
Okay, I guess.
Better?
Sure, I'm just tired.
I know. Anybody want some more?
No, I'm good. I miss Mr. Pearson.
John Marston, you're such a pig. All right, it's getting late. Let's get some rest. Good night, Jack.
Good night, Mama.
Good night, Jack.
Good night, Pa.
What the hell was that?
What are you doing?
My job, Abigail. Lock this door behind me. Don't open it unless you know it's me.
Jim! They got Dickens! Over by the stable!
Get the cattle out of here!
It's rich man's folly. You boys are over. The cattle are ours. And soon enough, their ranch will be...
This. New hand?
Come on. You got better than that.
What are you doing?
Dumb hicks.
They've killed Mr. Tolbert, and they've stolen my goddamn cattle. You men okay?
I think so.
Yeah?
Jim Milton saved my life. It's Mr. Abel.
Yeah, of course, it's Mr. Abel. I can't believe he thinks it can scare me out of here.
Then I guess we're getting your cattle back,
I guess we are. Can you go too, Tom?
Of course, sir.
All right, Jim. I know you can handle yourself.
A little.
Go get your guns and head out.
Guns?
Oh, don't play coy with me, son. We need your help. I don't care what you used to do or what your name is. This is the land of second chances.
Understood.
Okay.
Come in, it's me.
What was it?
Mr. Getty's cattle was taken.
I'm sorry to hear that. What are you doing in that thing?
Mr. Getty's been real good to us.
What are you doing?
My job, Abigail. My goddamn job.
I'll lead the way. This is gonna be the last we hear out of them.
Yeah! Yeah! Right!
Off your horses here. We'll be better on foot.
Okay.
If you say so.
That's the place up ahead.
There's our cows.
Lolo.
Couple guards out front. Couple more around the side, I imagine. Let's get a closer look. Let's go. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, 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 hello. Test, 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 test. Okay.
Plenty of guards.
We back.
I'm gonna head straight in.
Yep.
Tom, you head up there and try and give us some cover. Abe, you're gonna try and flank the place and come in from the back. I'll give you a minute or two, then I'm heading in.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay.
Hey! Hey! You boys been coming up to pro...
You done. You're gonna pay off.
Where are you, big fella?
Piss digging, shit shoveling, backwoods, sacker, no good trash. That woman of yours got the look of a woman ain't had a real ride in her life. She's gotta make do with some piss-poor stinking farmhand. Hey, hey, tell her I'll let her in my sheets. Long as she bathes first in sheet dip, get the stink of you off of her. Farmhand!
Mr. Milton, this man can really fight. Save the whole place.
Ah, that weren't nothing.
Well,
you! Oh, you! You saved my
life. No need to say nothing, sir. Just doing my job. Now,
I don't think they'll be back tonight, but how about Abe? Just in case you stay up.
Yep.
See anything or hear anything, you fire that rifle three times.
Three times.
We'll all come running.
Will do.
Well said. And thank you, Mr.
Sapino.
Truly.
Just glad to be of service, sir.
I understand. You get some rest.
Thank you, Mr. Geddes. What? What? What choice did I have? Just answer me that. What was I supposed to do?
Just do one thing or another. Not be two people at once. That's all I'm saying.
Yo, cow. Goodbye, cow.
Getting on?
Surviving, I think.
Apparently. I'll get you some coffee.
Only thing I know how to do is, well, no. Undertakers like me. Cattle, not so much.
That ain't true.
I ain't no rancher. Rustled horses, not raised them. Stole cattle, not birthed them.
I was reading the newspaper. I was reading about a old ranch, Beecher's Hope, down by Blackwater.
Was you?
Well, Jack read it to me, but I thought maybe we could raise some money. Bank could lend us the rest. We could be happy, John.
Loans? I got a goddamn price on my head, woman.
I know all about that. Every time we about to get somewhere, make something, you go and show the entire world that you ain't Jimmy Milton. Every place we've been has been the same. We start doing okay, and then boom. You act like the big man with the gun. Tired, John, and I guess I was dreaming a little. At least give me that.
Just feels hopeless.
You're doing better.
Milton! Milton, ma'am. Mr. Geddes needs you to head over to Strawberry in the wagon and collect some mail for him at the post office.
Sure. I'll take the boy with me. He's getting soft. Lancelot.
Come on. Jim, if you're heading that way, can you pick up a parcel for me? Address I ordered. I think it's in your name.
My name.
I think so. One's in your name, and the other one's in mine. Only one should have come in by now.
How much shopping you done?
Oh, yes. A real keen purchaser of goods, me. Look at me.
Okay, Lancelot. We'll make a man out of you yet.
Not too much of a man, mind. He's only a boy.
Just gonna show him how to drive the wagon a little. We'll save the real exciting realities of adulthood for another day. Come on, get!
You take care now.
Of course. It's nice getting out of the house, huh?
I like being in the house, Pa.
Life ain't just about doing things you like, boy.
What happened the other night with those men? Did you kill them?
I did what I had to do to protect you.
Pa! This isn't how you drive it. Ma said it was pride or something.
Ma. About that.
Want to take the reins a little?
I don't know, Pa.
It's easy, boy. Don't be scared.
Well, what do I do?
Well, just hold them and pull them short to slow down. Tell them to go faster. Give them a little switch. And then hold to one side if you want to turn. Here, try it out. Enough?
For now.
That kid's strawberry, eh, kid?
Looks like.
You know, I think this is the longest I've seen you without a book in your hand.
It was foolish to forget mine, sir.
Look, I got some business to attend to with the clerk. I leave you with the wagon. Can I trust you not to drive off with it?
Oh, I think I can be trusted to that.
Very good.
Sir? Why are you getting off the wagon?
Hello, sir.
I still remember that massacre of 99.
Terrible. This here's a tight community.
Here we are.
Remember, ain't nothing doesn't get
you back all right, any. Son?
Sure.
Well, cheer up a little. You wait here. I won't be long.
Okay.
And if you behave, I might let you drive us home.
Can't what?
Hi, I'm here to...
Name?
My name? Jim Milton.
Jim Milton. Hmm. Nope. Nothing here.
Maybe try... Marston. John Marston. It's a long story.
Okay. John Marston. Marston... Nope. Nothing here for that name either.
Try Abigail Roberts.
Abigail Roberts. Abigail Roberts. Yes. Here we are.
And also, I'm here to pick up the deliveries for Pronghorn Ranch. David Getty sent me.
Pronghorn? Yes. Sign here. We have a bunch of stuff for you. And I will help you out.
I'll take these. You get the rest of the stuff.
Oh, no.
Here, let me help you with this, Mr. Marston.
It's mostly Milton these days. It's a long story.
Whatever you say, Mr. Milton. It's not important. Take care now. Give my regards to Geddes.
Thank you very much, mister. Okay. Let's get out of here.
Everything okay, Pop?
Sure. I hope so, at least.
Here. You take the reins a little.
I ain't sure.
Come on, son. You'll enjoy it if you try a little harder.
Okay. Okay, Pa.
Yeah.
We're going back to Pronghorn, okay?
So, wait. We've come all the way out here and we're just gonna turn around and go back?
That's what we're doing. Turns out, I missed the seclusion of the ranch more than I figured for.
Don't you want to go to the store or the saloon or anywhere?
We're going back, okay, boy?
But I've been sitting in this wagon I don't know how long.
But nothing. Keep on driving, and watch the road.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Jesus. Mind your father, okay? I got my reasons, even if I don't care to explain them.
Yes, sir.
Better. tell you to speed up, speed up. If I say slow down, you slow down, okay?
Sure. Yeah.
All right, speed up. Let's get away from there.
Okay. Yeah.
Faster. Who's this?
Sorry, sir. Was that a question for me?
No. No, keep driving. Give him a switch.
I think we're going too fast, Pa.
Fine. Pull your reins in.
Well, I don't like driving across here.
It's the same as any other road. Look where you want to go and the horse will follow.
Okay. I think the horse is getting skittish.
He'll be all right.
What?
Nothing. Just keep driving.
Hold on.
Okay.
What? What's wrong?
Don't look around.
Oh, Pa, hey. Those men, are they following us?
Just stay calm. See that fallen tree? When we get there, stop the wagon, jump down, and hide.
Oh, Pa.
You need to do exactly as I say, boy. Here, now! Come on! Quick! Down! Okay, son. You wait here. You don't move or say nothing until I speak to you. You hear?
Yes, sir.
Head down. Okay, gentlemen. Let's see what you come calling about. What do you boys want with us?
Oh, we just want to have a friendly chat. Are you John Marshall? You sure look like him.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just here with my son.
Did you kill a fella out in Roanoke a few months back?
No. Wasn't me.
That was my brother.
I'm real sorry, friend, but he was trying to rob.
You're talking bullshit, mister. Kill him.
Why? What?
It's okay. Come on. Keep them eyes closed. Let's go. Come on. Giddy up.
Oh, dear. Those men.
I told you not to look, boy.
Are they dead?
I didn't have much of a choice. You saw that. Now, compose yourself.
You killed them, Pa.
Son, I need you to hold it together.
Just stay on the road.
You were real brave back there. Real brave. Did exactly like I said.
Really?
Uh-huh. If you hadn't listened, things could have gone real wrong for us.
You're going so fast.
You know, your mama wants us to buy some old ranch. You read to her about it, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
What was it called?
Why you drive like this?
Mm-hmm. What was the name, boy?
Peacher's Hole.
That's right. Peacher's Hole. Over by Blackwater. You like the idea of that, huh? Us on the ranch.
This is real fast. I don't know.
I can see you as a ranch boy. Like Duncan Geddes, huh? I wasn't so sure, but... yeah. That kind of life might suit us. Wouldn't be such a chore if the horses we were cleaning up after was ours, would it? No, it wouldn't. Mm. Okay, here we are. That was an...
How was the... What happened?
Yeah. It's... I don't... We got shot at.
Shot at? What happened?
Well, we got followed, and then...
Followed by who?
Probably someone who knew me. If we didn't get to them particulars, I'm sorry.
My son. Our son!
It was your dress that caused all the problem.
It weren't even a dress. It was a gift for you.
Hey, Mr. Jim? Mr. Jim?
Hey.
There's a telegram messenger for you over there in, near the house.
There is? Okay. Thanks, Abe.
What do you think he wants?
I have no idea. But I doubt someone wants to give me a big pile of money.
That's him.
I see him. Thanks, Abe. Excuse me, mister. I'm Jim Milton. Heard you had a telegram for me?
Yes. Here. Sign there.
Thank you.
Huh?
Jim, stop. If you're the JM I know, stop. It's Sadie Adler. I've got something to discuss. Pay good. Meet me in saloon in Valentine. I'm there most days. Stop. Sadie Adler. I'll be damned. Abigail. Darling John, a kind lady in the village helped me write this.
She had men problems of her own, but that's a different story. Listen, I've begged you, but it don't seem to make much difference. I've tried everything I know to make you grow up. And you know I love you, but loving you means I can't watch you do this. Time after time, we've had to run because of your behavior and your decisions. We got a son. I got a son. And I love our son enough that I can't have him around while you're like this. I had so many dreams, John. I hoped you would change. We all saw what happened to them that didn't, but you... part of you is hell-bent on ending up the same way.
And I love you too much to watch that no more. Abigail.
Where's the wife, Milton?
She's out.
I saw her leaving with the boy and the bags. What's going on?
You married Mr. Dickens?
No.
That don't surprise me.
What'd she do? Catch you with a showgirl? Or hear about you shooting more fellas over by Strawberry? Just who are you, Jim Milton?
I'm a family man. I can handle a gun, sure. Them men shot at me.
Just interested, that's all.
Ain't nothing interesting, unless you find gossip about a man's marriage worthy of your time.
Guess not. There's work to be done, unless you're running off too.
I ain't going nowhere. I'm here to work. Gotta save money, get her what she wants.
What does she want?
She wants a place of her own. Said she found a plot up at Beatrice Hope.
You? A rancher? You'll starve.
Probably.
Keep yourself busy. Take your mind off it.
Some poor dumb bastard tried to rob me last weekend. He was busting my hand and he was hidden.
That's her fool.
Hey, you know, I was wrong about you. You turned into a fine worker, Jim Milton.
Oh, thank you. Means a lot. Hey, you think I could speak with Mr. Geddes? See if maybe he's open to offering me some guidance?
I'm sure he'd be happy to hear you speak, at least.
Thank you, Mr. Dickens. Hey, son. How's that bull?
Fine, Mr. Milton.
Your father in? Can I have a word?
Sure. I'll just get him.
Pa!
I'm right here. What's the problem, Milton?
I'm sorry for the disturbance, sir.
Oh, no problem. My wife, she just began her morning discourse on the subject of my faults. Experience I think every man can relate to.
In some ways, my wife also has issues with some of the decisions I've made. Real issues.
Hmm?
Do you believe a man can change, sir?
Where is this heading?
I guess I don't know. I've tried to be a good hand. I've worked hard to secure your property.
And for that, we are grateful.
And you've paid me well besides. The thing is, I suppose, I need to get a place of my own so I can prove to my wife that I've changed.
I understand.
But I ain't got much money. I ain't asking to borrow none. But maybe you could go to the bank and put in a good word so they could give me a loan.
A loan, huh?
So I can buy that place, Beecher's Hope?
Yes, I know it. Yes, of course, sure. It'd be my pleasure. But take my advice, Milton. Take your money and go buy passage on a boat. Go to Brazil and forget all about family. I'm just joking, son. Just make sure you deal with Ansel Atherton at the bank. He's a distant cousin. Here's my name. Tell him to ask me direct himself. You'll get what you need.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I was young and dumb once, too. You'll get her back.
Marston is back, boys. back. Let's play. Where do we go? Where do we go? Oh my gosh. Do we go to Abigail? Okay, let's go to the Blackwater.
Must I go on? Cruel, cruel world, I'm moving on. I've been living too fast, and I've been living too long. Cruel, cruel world, I'm gone. This big old world sure got me running round. I heard a voice that said, just settle down. And with the moonlight as my guide, and with this feeling deep inside, I know now that I am homeward bound. Cruel, cruel world, must I go home? Cruel, cruel world, I'm moving on. I've been living too fast, and I've been living too wrong. Cruel, cruel world, I'm gone. Dusty trail, saw a vapor light. Was it a mirage? I don't know, but it seemed right. I felt mission, I felt trust. I knew then that I must just go to her from this cruel world. Cruel, cruel world, must I go?
Hey! Move it! Let's go, girl. You're doing well.
You want to dust up? You've got it.
Calm down, for God's sake.
Ain't this fun? Over here.
The curse.
Hey, here. Are you crazy?
Hello. Looking for a trim?
what?
All right, stranger. Excuse me, sir. Can I help you?
I see our share of bad luck just showing up.
Yeah. I'm looking for Mr. Atherton. I'm a friend of Mr. Getty's over at Pronghorn Ranch.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Atherton is in his office. Hey, please head in.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Can I help you?
I hope so. I want a loan, sir. A line of credit, so I can buy some property.
What property?
An old ranch, Beecher's Hope.
That old dump?
I know it ain't much, but I ain't much of a farmer either. But I will get there.
That is a very unusual way of asking for a loan. Mr.
Marston.
Marston.
Only folk around here call me Milton. It's kind of a joke, I guess.
A joke, huh? And which folk?
Mr. Getty's. Uh-huh. I work for him. He said that you could help me out. I mean, if you can.
So old David Getty's told you I'm the kind of man to loan a man with two names money so he can buy a run-down farm on account of his lack of farming skills, huh?
Don't sound too promising when you put it like that.
Well, how would you put it?
Sorry to waste your time, sir.
Oh, sit down. I'm sure we can figure something out. Now, of course, we'll be expecting you to make regular payments, and given a lack of much evidence you got any means of repaying, the terms won't be too great. But if my cousin vouches for you, it'll be okay with the bank.
Really?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Now, of course, we'll be expecting our money back regular as clockwork until the debt's settled. Otherwise, the farm reverts to the bank, no matter how much you paid.
I understand.
Well, why don't you go check out the land while I fix the contracts and talk to Mr. Getty's. Oh, I heard there's squatters up there. We've been having so many problems recently, they'll need clearing on.
Sure.
Well, come back when you're done, and we'll fix up the paperwork.
Blind. Help a blind man.
Okay, here you are.
You're a fool, fiend, but not so much of a fool as you think, nor such a fiend. The past is done, and the future yet to come.
All right, mister.
Come here! We're off! You're a good filly. No! Hold it there! Okay, missy. Hold up, will you?
Jesus,
don't
anyone.
Do anything
help.
Stupid.
Mr. Abel Stucks been wanting us to sign our land over. Only this time I escaped, but they have my husband. They're gonna kill him.
Abel Stucks, huh? Where are they?
It's the stone farmhouse back there where I came from.
I'll head there now.
I'll see about finding more help.
Take a long time on you.
Just do it. You're gonna do it. They're killers. Get them.
The hell?
Hey, untie me, will you? Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you. Those goddamn bastards deserve that and more. My wife. You seen my wife by any chance?
Yeah, I saw her. West of here. She told me to come find you.
Oh, thank God. But thank you for hearing her call.
Come on, lady.
Where are you, my dearest?
Ain't you special? Look out!
I don't understand this at all. Hey, over here!
What's the problem?
Problem? No, there's no problem. Quite the contrary. Well, there is a problem. For me, but not for you.
All right. I don't have time for this.
No, wait! Give me a minute of your life. I might just change it forever. I'm sure you will have heard of me. Máximo Cristóbal Valdespino, the renowned explorer.
No, can't say I have.
There has been much written about me. I once had high tea with the Viceroy of India. I helped liberate South America. I've climbed mountains and swum across seas. I have had many women. I've spent the last 3 months hunting treasure on the American frontier. Beautiful country. Reminds me a lot of Almeria. But tomorrow I set sail for the island of Shikoku in the Japanese archipelago in search of the legendary Tokushima Sapphire.
Okay. Good for you.
No, hold on. You see this map here? It was made by the Jack Hall gang. They robbed banks all the way from here to California.
I know who the Jack Hall gang are.
Oh, them you have heard of, but me? Well, rumor has it, they buried gold somewhere in this area, but were killed before they could retrieve it. They created 2 maps to ensure it was well hidden. This is the first and should lead you to the second. You just need to follow the landmarks drawn here.
Me?
Yes. Unfortunately, I am out of time now, but I am prepared to sell it to you for the low price of $10. A trifling investment for a man such as you, given the potential returns.
Well, I'm interested in the map. Not so interested in the haggle. Why don't you just hand it over instead?
Yes, you're funny.
Listen, give me the map. I'm done asking.
Oh my, here, take it. Just...
Quick, come on! partner! Come on!
What's your problem?
Well, all right.
Hard.
Take it easy.
Come on now. Get him.
Hello, sir.
I thought I told you to leave it, Bubba.
And I thought to myself, who this little girl thinks she's telling anything to?
Enjoy your drink in peace. I ain't got no business with you right now.
What that mean?
For the last time, leave me alone!
Or what?
What that?
Get the hell out of here before she kills us all!
You!
Get out of here!
John Marston!
It is good to see you.
I thought I heard a rumor he was alive. Jim Milton, that you?
Guess I didn't do a real good job of hiding my identity. We didn't hear nothing about you.
You killed feller up by Roanoke?
Sure did.
I thought that sounded like you and Abigail and Jack. She's
fine.
She was always so kind to me.
I'm looking to buy some property. Beecher's Hope, west of Blackwater. I'm kind of a farmer now. And you?
You know how it is. Bounties mostly, and some other stuff, good and bad. Hey, you any interest in bounties?
I've gone straight. Huh? Sort of.
Oh, it's legal, usually.
Then, maybe.
Come on, then.
What? Where are we headed?
Strawberry. Guy on the run from New York. Good price for him.
What'd he do?
Rob a bank.
With a gun?
Nope, with a pan. He's an accountant, I think.
Sounds easy.
Come on, we got a bit of a ride.
I know. Hello. Your telegram. You said you had something to discuss. I didn't think we'd be chasing down an outlaw.
There's something else.
What?
Micah.
Micah?
I think so. I heard of someone sounded like him. About a year back?
Okay.
We always said, if we found him...
I know what we said we did. Ah! That ain't changed.
I didn't think I'd see any of you again after you left for the Yukon.
Now we came back. Didn't strike it rich, as you can see.
But you're a rancher now.
I aim to be. Probably why I can't afford it. This country's becoming real civilized. Bad folk won't be around for long.
there, friend. How can I help you?
All right. See what you can find. Like I said, feller's name is Nathan Kirk. Banker. Bald. 45.
Okay.
You head up that way. I'll meet you in a bit.
You seen a fella? A fella from New York? Bald guy?
Yeah. A few New Yorkers come here in search of the West.
This one's a wanted man. I work for the government. Sort of. His name's Nathan Kirk.
Mr. Kirk? But he's so charming.
Is he staying here?
He's, up in room 3.
I'm gonna go pay him a visit. It's government business.
How exciting.
Mr. Kirk! Mr. Kirk, you in there?
Who is it?
Stop! Hey! That's Nathan Kirk! So, got him?
Oh, shut up! Come on, jump on!
Okay.
We gotta get after him. Remember, we want him alive, though.
I know.
Sorry, guys. I died.
Oh, damn.
Mr. Kirk! Mr. Kirk, you in there?
Who is it?
It's just a friend. Just a friend! Stop! Hey! That's Nathan Kirk! Oh, got him?
Oh, shut up! Come on, jump on! We gotta get after him! Remember, we want him alive, though!
I know!
You got there.
Now hold still, mister. Thanks for that, Mr. Kirk. Real fun.
I'm an innocent man, but...
Hey, quiet now.
Where shall I send the money? I ain't been paid yet.
Send it on my behalf to West Elizabeth Cooperative Bank in Blackwater. Pay down my loans. Might make them happy to see I've got a boss.
No, I've got a couple of other leads I could use your help with if you're interested. I'm usually at the saloon in Blackwater.
I need money pretty bad, so I'll come find you. Easy there!
Take no guff from this one.
Friend?
I hope so. Who's in charge here?
No one, mister. This is a free country.
Now that I ain't so sure about. Listen, I'm buying this land. I'm afraid you guys are gonna have to go somewhere else.
Who's this?
I ain't sure. Some fancy Dan city boy says he owns this land. Or he's gonna.
Owns it?
That's what he says.
Okay. And how come we live in here?
I ain't sure.
Get the hell out of here. This land belongs to me now.
Ain't nothing on this earth belongs to no one, partner.
Looks like you made your decision then, partner.
Ah!
about you? The man with two names and no past. Come on in. How'd you make out?
Well, let's just say there are no more squatters.
Okay. Well, I got your paperwork ready. Now, you sure about buying this place? It's really run down, and the price isn't too great.
I think it would mean a lot for my wife. At least mean I was listening to her.
Okay. Well, sign here and here. Now we own you, Mr. Marston, and we own Mr. Milton, too, and we own your property. But you can buy your freedom each week. Eventually, you will be a homeowner.
I understand.
Congratulations. You are now a real American, indebted and owned by the bank. I'm joking. They own me. They just own your property. Now, you can also use this line of credit for any home improvements you need to make, of course.
I can?
Sure. Be good, Mr. Marston. Welcome to home ownership. It's a beautiful thing. Let your wife know what to complain about. I'm just joking.
Well, it is you. Well, I never. I thought you was dead, boy. Dead.
Uncle?
The very same. Come here. I saw you going into the bank, and by the looks of things, you ain't robbed it.
I've gone straight.
Oh, bull crap.
No, for real. Well, I'm trying.
All these years, you ain't changed a bit. Maybe a little bit. I thought you was dead.
Not yet. Well, I got some things to take care
of. No, not a problem. I'll come too.
No, you don't have to.
Oh, I'm real sick, John. Lumbago. It's a slow and painful death, my brother.
Evidently.
Have a little pity, will you? Huh?
Come on, then.
All right.
All right, girl. Follow me. Maldito loco! West!
West? Oh, ain't you a man of few words? I can see we're headed west. Just wait right there for me. Dear Lord, wrong way.
Keep going, girl. You're okay.
Monosyllables don't make you seem interesting. It makes you seem stupid.
I don't care how I seem.
Well, now, where west are we headed, you damn grunting fool?
This ranch I bought just now.
Is that what you were doing in the bank? Spending all your money? Oh, I want a ranch in the armpit of West Elizabeth. Oh, my Lord.
Not that that's any of your concern, but I was in the bank borrowing the money.
Well, that's even worse. Yeah, you can run from a bounty, John. You can't run from a bank. Is Abigail there?
No. She's, her and Jack are waiting until I'm set up before joining me out here.
You mean she left you? Oh, I never thought she was a smart woman, but, you know, this makes me think maybe I was wrong.
No more of that. Just bought this place, and you're lucky I'm showing it to you, and not looking for a place to bury you out here. This is it. Look at her.
Okay.
What do you think?
Why exactly did you buy this dump?
For Abigail?
Why? Is she an idiot?
No.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. She said she wanted it.
She ever seen it? What are we gonna farm here? Rocks?
We?
You don't have a hope here without a wise hand at the tiller.
Enough of that. Get out of here. On your way.
No. You're stuck with me. Seems I'm stuck with you. John, the rock farmer.
So, you think I'm an idiot?
No. I know you're an idiot.
I ain't gonna do nothing you don't want me to. Nice and easy. There, there. How you feel about this, huh? Easy! You finished? Can you calm down? Okay! Laughing at me, aren't you? Now, why'd you do that? Now, where are you off to? You don't need to do that. Hello. I'm gonna keep at this, you know.
the lumbago. Now, if I overdo it, I'll get a relapse. It's very serious.
Get up or get out.
You can be so testy. What is it, constipation?
Guess you're my proof I'll never quite outrun my sins.
You got so sanctimonious in your old age. No wonder she left you. It's like rooming with the King James Bible.
Get up!
Ow! I'm getting up. Oh, no, what did I have to tell you? I went into town. I got a little drunk. Oh, shit! Well, we gotta go. We gotta go to Saint Denis. Charles Smith is alive, I reckon.
Charles Smith alive? Really?
I reckon. Unless I dreamed it all, and by the sound of it, not doing too good neither. Here we are.
Come on, let's get off.
All right. Yeah.
Back in Saint Denis. I never liked this place.
Yeah, me neither. All right. Let's go find that big sour bastard.
Sure. Let's split up.
Good idea. I'll take the saloons, you take the slums.
How about I take the saloons, and you take the slums?
Don't you just love the feel of the sun on your face?
Sir, welcome to Horner & Co. Shelves are all labeled up top. You don't see something, just check the catalog. Take a study. Let me know what catches your eye. Okay. Well, if you change your mind. Appreciate it. Enjoy it.
Thanks, partner. Come on, then.
Bonjour. How can I help you today, sir?
Listen, you seen a big Indian fella?
Huh. Indian?
Yeah. A boxer.
No. Sorry, mister. No. Actually, yes. I think he's fighting, I believe. Fighting out behind Saint Saturnine.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
No problem.
Oh, good Lord. I was just beginning to enjoy some peace and quiet.
Ask that first barman I met. He told me Charles was here.
Folks, they love a surprise.
Not one of life's great mysteries, it turns out.
And you are a killer. We both know what you gotta do. I'm leaving now.
He don't know the half of it.
John?
You're... I'm alive. So are you. So's he.
That's Uncle?
What are you doing?
I don't know. I'm alive.
Uncle thought maybe you was in some sort of trouble.
Kind of, just... I don't know. I'm throwing fights for a few dollars.
Throwing fights?
Sure.
And you like that?
Of course not.
So...
Let me go place a bet. Come on. Man, I thought you were dead.
Sure. Abigail's still alive, too, only she left me.
Excuse me. I'd like to place a bet.
On who?
On myself, to win. Lone Wolf.
How much?
All of this.
Okay. Funny thing, I pegged you for the favorite, but the odds just got real good. What about you, sir? A little wager on the wolf here? Real redskin brave.
Sure, I'm a fan of the wolf. Give me a bet on him.
Have I got a treat for you? An epic battle between the descendant of ancient warriors and a not-so-noble savage. On my left, a ferocious battler from the valleys, Simon of Wales. And on my right, an Injun Hercules. The savage, the untamable, the unbeaten, and dare I say unbeatable, Lone Wolf. You know how this works. No weapons, no forfeiting, no crying like a beaten child. Everything else goes. You win by knockout, you win by retirement, or you win by death. Let's have a good fight, boys. Let's keep it clean, but not so clean.
Out just yet. Hit him, Charles.
What is this?
Pretend he's Micah.
Hit him.
Lone Wolf. You ain't no kind of fighter.
Stop this.
You're about to see some stars. Knock him out. Try and stay on your feet, you hear? Hit him, Lone Wolf. Don't back out just yet. You're fighting with him. Come on, Lone Wolf. Gotta get you the hell out of here.
Hey! Lone Wolf! Whoa! How? Made my month, but you also made some fellas mighty unhappy.
So it goes.
Here's your share, partner.
If we'd just made the bed, I said we
should. So you keen on staying around here or heading off with me and Uncle?
But, John, I haven't seen you two in years.
I know. But right now, my sense is you just need to lie low.
Where?
We got a little place up past Blackwater, in the high country.
Okay. I gotta grab my baggage. I booked a steamer heading upriver. That's why I was pretending to throw the fight.
Okay, boys. I'll meet you at the bridge outside Saint Denis.
What are you doing?
Just have a few errands to run.
You're useless.
I am a deep thinker.
Be quick.
Come on. This way. My bag's on the dock side. So, what happened?
You mean back then? Arthur helped me get out. Gave me a chance to live, I guess. You know that Arthur...
Sure. Word got to me up north, so I went back and buried him in Miss Grimshaw.
I had to run. If any of us had been found, we'd have...
Oh, of course. I understand. He's where he would have wanted to be. Pretty hillside, facing the evening sun.
He gave me his satchel and some of his things in it. Remember that journal he always drew in? I got it. I'm a bit of a draftsman myself nowadays.
He was a good man. As much as any of us could be.
Getting sick like that has to rattle a fella.
Rattling or and give him some kind of understanding what his life was really all about.
Yeah? That makes sense.
Anyway, I heard all of you were dead. Or I might have come looking.
And me, the same about you.
Dutch?
Who knows? Dead? Maybe? I'm not sure. I heard all kind of things, but one thing I know, he ain't around here. I ain't heard nothing real in years since, well, that time.
Nor me. Micah.
I hope that bastard's dead. You know, he was the one speaking to them agents.
What?
Putting them on us the whole time. Or since before I got off Sisica.
They picked up Strauss. The agents. Made a real mess of him. I heard he died in custody. Never said a word.
Guess some folk is strong in ways you can't see.
Everything that happened. All those deaths. Micah?
None of us is innocent in that. Dutch, least of all. But I don't think we would have had to make those calls. All that mayhem. If it wasn't for...
Okay.
Hold on.
What?
Careful.
Why?
Those are Guido Martelli's men.
Who?
He used to work for Angelo Bronte.
I've only been here an hour.
Hey! Come over here.
What now?
Well, you go left, I go right. On three.
Mm-hmm.
Three!
You couldn't have thrown that fight!
It's never just one fight.
Let's go. There's a wagon up there. Look at my back.
Okay.
Uncle gonna meet us?
Over the bridge going out of town. West.
You don't need the attention.
Hold on.
What the hell?
You see any law?
Not yet.
Keep your eye out. San Denis ain't short on police.
I remember that. Only too well.
Anyone?
Good so far. The further we get from those gunshots, better chance we have. Of denying it, at least.
No. We can't get caught. Martelli has the police chief in his pocket. If they take us in, we won't get out of the interview room.
I don't want to get a shoot. Out over this. That's not the man I try to be anymore.
No, I don't want that either. You see anything?
I think we're clear. If I ever want to go back, remind me that I hate Saint Denis.
Guido Martelli will happily remind you of that.
Give me some simple folk and wide open spaces. Speaking of simple...
John! Charles! You boys been off getting up to no good?
Kind of. Been getting shot at.
Well, they weren't very good shots. Come on, let's head for home.
I'll be trying online. Let's try this.
Devices.
Hello.
What's up, what's up? Map looks like. Okay, spoiler.
Hello. You must, you must be a Harley's friend.
He's one of us. He said you also were a discouraged man. I'm very discouraged. Disappointed, Alden. That's me. Anyway, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. I find your reticence charming. Real charming. By the way, I heard you might want to earn a little money. Well, some gentlemen have been robbing our stages, and they are not part of the club, if you catch my meaning. If you can make them go away, I'm sure they will have something of interest to you. They're up at Blue Water Marsh. See what you can do, okay? Here, by the way, a catalog. The latest issue. Just came into this armpit from a land more civilized. And if all works out well, my colleagues and I move around these stations as needed. And all of us are very discouraged. We will all help a fellow sufferer with pertinent information. Good afternoon, sir.
You're good. You're real good, friend.
this.
The map. Just be kind.
I win again. Did Hortley send you, Pop? I'm Clay Davies. This is my brother,
Clive.
He don't talk. Maybe you two will get along better. Maybe not. Listen, I heard you wanted to earn some money. So, there's a gang of ne'er-do-wells. They are a bunch of degenerates, not good people. They're out in Rhodes with a bunch of horses they stole off of me. Well, that's a lie, but they stole them off a fella I was gonna steal them off of. Maybe you could get them for me. You think you could do that for me, Pop? Looks like you're doing this on your own. Well, good. Meet me at the stable at Saint Denis once you have the horse flesh, and I'll pay you good. Oh, and Pop, Horley wanted me to remind you any decent work you can find, take it. But just try to stay out of trouble. Oh, and once you give me those horses, well, after that, we'll talk again. Oh, I do so enjoy these conversations. I'm used to them on account of my brother. Let's go, Clive!
up, what's up?
About you, dead right. Ain't that dandy? Get that horse hidden away, Clive, and ready to move out as soon as we can. Here's some money you earned. Now listen, Horley came by and gave me a message. He said to go see your friend Cripps up at your camp. Now listen to me for a second. Any other decent horses you find, we'll buy them just as soon as we are set up, okay? Nice meeting you. You know what? Hold on, boy. I call him boy because I'm older. 30 minutes, he went black. Let's give our friend here back the horse. It's yours. A sign of faith and future business. If you want to buy any extras or sundries for the animal, head inside. They've got a lot available. See you soon. Come on, Clive.
head still rolling from the road.
You want to see what I can do with a shooter?
How do you get on with Clay Davies? Horrible little wretch, in my opinion. Pop this and pop that. I'd like to pop him, a slime bucket. Anyway, I've got everything set up. Well, what we have so far, place is pretty nice. I think you did a good job for you. I'll earn my keep. When you get too old to fight, what choice have you got? It's either work or beg. I'd rather work. Oh, I saw Horley. Now, he wants you to come down and meet him in Blackwater when you get a chance. I think he might have some work for you. Oh, and while you're out on your travels, you may see some folk with employment opportunities. Good folk, bad folk, looking for a tough guy with a gun to help them. Up to you if you listen to them, I guess. You know, I used to like that kind of stuff. One time, I almost helped a clown steal an elephant. But that's a very silly story. Welcome home. Make yourself at home. It is your home.
Hello there. Hi, babe. Okay, mic off again. Bye.
need. All right, you know where to find me.
I don't know what's happening. Wait. Fix color. Yeah. Wait, my baby.
Mm-hmm. Can you see me now?
Wait a minute, my baby.
Oh shit, I have enemies. Oh shit, I died!
See you again tomorrow. Bye.